As your team grows, having safer workflows to collaborate at scale becomes extremely important. That's when the default roles like designer or content editor can start to feel too broad. They don't always map neatly to specific responsibilities your team actually needs. In this video, we're going to walk through how enterprise custom roles work in Webflow. And we'll do it in 15 steps, except we won't. We'll do it in 3 steps. First, we'll create a custom role. Then, assign that custom role to our teammates. And finally, we'll look at some examples of what custom roles can do in Webflow. Let's get right into it. Here, in our workspace dashboard, we'll navigate to our team tab. We have our users, where we can invite members to our workspace and change their roles. And then we have roles. This is where the magic happens. Right now, we don't have a custom role created, which is exactly why we're here. Below, we see the default roles: site manager, designer, marketer, content editor, and the reviewer. These are the standard roles that already come with set permissions. And the custom roles we create, they are based on these default roles. But we'll go up here and create a new custom role. For this one, let's create a junior designer custom role, or associate designer, whatever you like to call it. Someone who can make design changes across the site, but needs a senior member of the team to decide when to publish to production. We'll add the role title, and we'll give this role a description here, just pasting it in from my clipboard. This is the text that shows up when someone's assigning a role to a user, so it's helpful to make it short and concise. We want to base this role on the default designer role, so let's select that role. Once we do, we're offered some permissions options to customize this role. For publishing, we want this junior designer role to be able to publish the full site to staging and be allowed to publish CMS items to production. And for build and review, we want them to be allowed to make changes without approval. With these elections, we're making sure they can safely test and review their work without the risk of publishing live, but still have that flexibility to push individual CMS items live to production. And with those selected, we'll go up and create this new custom role. And then we'll actually create that role. Now we can see our new custom role. However, no one is assigned to it yet. So let's move on to the next step and assign a member to this new custom role. We'll go over to our users tab. Now, if we open the roles option, we can select the custom role we just created. This custom role now becomes their default for new sites they're added to, but you can still override it per site. Okay, that's assigning a custom role to a member, or even members in our team. Let's look at some examples, more custom roles in action in Webflow. In addition to our junior designer role, we now have a growth marketer role and a junior content editor role. These are just common setups we've seen. Of course, you can customize roles however you want. We have the junior designer role we created just a moment ago, which is great for designers who are new to Webflow and need to safely explore without breaking anything. They can do everything the designer role can do, design with classes, components, and interactions, but we gave them permission to publish the full site to staging. When they go up here to the publishing workflow, they cannot publish to the live production site. And when working with CMS content, they're able to publish CMS content to the live production site as needed. What about the growth marketer role? This role is ideal for marketers who need to build landing pages using designer-approved building blocks and also need access to site settings for things like SEO. It's based on the marketer role, but we customized it so they can make changes without needing approval, and they can manage site settings. However, they can't publish to production, so that permission stays unchecked. In Webflow, that means they can create landing pages using pre-built components, adjust SEO settings, and edit what they need, all without the risk of pushing something live before it's ready. And finally, our last example, we have the junior content editor, which is ideal for team members who need to get content ready without publishing or launching it. That role is based on the content editor role, but for this custom role, they only need to author new CMS content in our sites, so we didn't enable any additional permissions. And in Webflow, in this site here, that junior content editor role allows them to safely and securely edit content, create or edit CMS items, and change images without the risk of publishing something live that hasn't been approved yet. These are just a handful of examples of how you can set up custom roles for your team. And actually, at this very moment, there are already 674 role variations you can put together for your specific needs. And you can always go back and edit or fine-tune any custom role later. That's it. We showed how to create a new custom role. We then assigned a member to that role. And finally, we covered or showed examples of a few custom roles that allow you to successfully and safely work together in Webflow. That's enterprise custom roles in Webflow.